It's crazy when life throws you a curveball. Sometimes the obstacles are tough. They're meant to challenge you, meant to make you grow. But those will be the same obstacles that are meant to lift you, to enlighten you, to remind you that you do have greatness within you.
He's known for a couple of reasons. But I know him for his music. He's here with us today. Give it up for High Tone.
Snapbacks on, head tats, no problems. Ink slingers, bitch, zucchini and shrimp pasta. Mama always told me, mijo, be yourself. But the game's so racist, they don't want no brand. So I did what I did. I said and wrote in the whip. I said, you gon' have to love me cause my hustle was big. Everybody eating Mexican food, but they don't wanna hear the Mexican dude. Everybody eating Mexican food, but they don't wanna hear the Mexican dude.
Okay, Sway in the morning. I don't even have a tap, but after talking to him, I might get one.
Yeah.
Hear me.
Sway, High Tone.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Rico and Mambo Morning Show. We got High Tone in the house.
In the house with us right now, West Covina's own man. High Tone, what's going on, brother?
Man, how you doing, guys?
In
how
the
you
building.
Doing, hey, don't try to be. Don't
do it.
I got the deep voice.
Honestly,
don't do that.
Nah,
stay in your lane.
Kind of comparing,
you know, put your blinker on.
Nah, hey, hey. If you see my snap, you know I got this voice here, baby. So, nah, but I'm, you know, I'm just blessed to be in this building.
Man, the thing, no Xanax needed. Was created in the West Coast. And I'm all the way on the East Coast, man. To think that this project, I mean, touched that many lives and it's really changing, you know, the way people really feel about what they're going through and not ashamed of how they're feeling, man. That's what it is. That's what real music's about. That's what vulnerability is about. That's what High Tone is about.
No Xanax Needed is not only a stance I took medically and physically during one of the hardest times in my life. It's a philosophy I've adopted, a way of life. Knowing the easy way is not always the best way. This project wasn't masterminded or synthetically created. It's real and it's raw. It's a journey I wanted to share with you about my greatest fall in hopes I will pull you out of yours.
We all feel like we're failures at one point. We all feel like maybe this wasn't for me. We all feel like maybe I should just hang this shit up, you know? 10 years later, still no hit. No plaques on the wall, boy, still no kiss. No big features like Cola Wiz. I fell a whole lot of times, still I ain't quit.
I just released, you know, No Xanax Needed. Independently charted number 6 on iTunes. Man, I'm just blessed right now. You see, I got a lot of attention throughout the NXN experience. The project came from such a vulnerable and authentic place that it resonated with people around the world. But somehow, despite the great heights I reached, I still haven't hit my peak. I still haven't made it to the top. I'm still struggling to find a place in this game. I remember as a youngster, I listened to nothing but hip-hop. I mean, everything from Wu-Tang, A Tribe Called Quest, Dr. Dre, Jay-Z, Snoop, Tupac. I grew up on nothing but the classics. So let's get to the facts. Aside from the occasional artist, hip-hop has been dominated by race as far back as I could remember. You would be hard-pressed to name one Mexican-American mainstream artist. Not Puerto Rican, not Dominican, not Peruvian, not Cuban. Even with nearly 50% of LA's population being Hispanic, that's 4.6 million people. A Los Angeles-based Mexican-American rapper still can't get a spin on LA's most predominant hip-hop stations. And that's crazy to me because we're known for being hard workers and we're known for being talented. You know, I'm not saying I'm the first one of my kind to try to break down this barrier, but I feel year after year and time after time we keep getting passed up.
Sitting in the park on a Sunday afternoon, me and the crew just jamming the oldie tune, sipping on a cold bottle of brewski.
Before I throw a solo, never try to sweat me. Some of you don't know what's happening, que pasa's not for you anyway, cause this is for the Raza.
Turned off the sound system to the sound of Carlos Santana. In the
You know, it's a new day and age. It's time to unite. It's time to break down the door in a real way. It's time to let our people know we got a voice too.
Talk about the bullshit.
Bullshit, because you're a chick, bullshit because you're whatever, you know? Bullshit because you're white sometimes, or Mexican, or whatever the fuck.
Give me like an example of the bullshit.
I feel like I've been snubbed.
Snubbed?
Yeah. I feel like there's definitely been certain things that I either should have won, or should have appeared in, or should have done, based on numbers, and they haven't. You know, sometimes somebody else gets it, or somebody else manages some chick that something, and it's always so, you know, that it's always so petty. And you know, whenever people are like, oh, that's why music is fucking up. No, music is fucking up because people are like, the people in the music industry are fucking it up.
Even though it's kind of contradicting what we represent, because we always want to represent that we're proud of being Mexican, you know what I'm saying, that we got each other's back. But at the same time, and I don't give a fuck who gets offended by this, that unity is not there. You know what I'm saying? It's just not there.
I did feel like it was harder for a Hispanic rapper to crack into the game.
The problem is...
At the time. The problem is, when you were coming through...
The problem is, it's still hard.
I mean, to be honest, I'm just tired of being put in a box. I'm tired of everybody putting my race before my rap name. And, I mean, it just ain't sitting right with me, you know what I'm saying? And I don't feel like anybody should be judged or put in a category just off of the skin color or background or ethnicity. It's like, if you like my music, then you like it. If you don't, then you don't. We all have opinions, we all have ears, but why is your eyes judging the music when your ears should be judging the music?
Black love, brown pride in the sets again.
I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall. Yeah. Mark my words.
Yeah. Hold up, I fuck with Mexicans, got a plug with Mexicans. When a little need a switch, who I call Mexican. This Comedy Central ass nigga come be the president. Hold up, Nip, tell the world how you fuck with Mexicans.
It wouldn't be the USA without Mexicans, and if it's time to team up, shit, let's begin. Black love, brown pride in the sets again.
But the silver lining is, I'm a man of my word. I'm ride or die. I'm top of the food chain till my brain hangs. And there ain't no way around it. For my family, for those who share my passion, my motivation, and those who know the true meaning of TFC. For those of you who know, embrace, and rep the movement, you know there's nothing that will stop me from putting out that shit you know, you love, and you vibe to. I'm here to prove good music has no color lines, no ceiling is too high to touch, and no obstacle is too large to overcome. I paid my price. I paid the price of admission to get in this game. No matter who tries to silence me, ignore me, or push me aside, I won't remain silent, because I am the voice.
They said if I was black, I would have blew up. They said if I was white, I would have blew up. Think y'all acting racist like Adolf. Remember the end of the story, Hitler blew his brain out.
This is me. This is raw. This isn't for the industry. It's not for the cameras. It's not for social media. I am who I am, and I'm proud of being who I am. I'm a Mexican-American from a little city called Covina that has big dreams. Big dreams of being global. You know, I never wanted to just... So many people get comfortable with local stardom, local success. And each of us have a different definition of success. My success is to take this, sky's the limit. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I am about. That's what TFC's about. That's what this journey that I'm on is about, is continuing to do the things that I love for the people that I love.